Hey guys, we're Evan and Caitlin, and today we're going to be casting metal. What are you doing in our shop?
Thank you NordVPN for sponsoring this video. Check them out at nordvpn.com/Evan and Caitlin and use code Evan and Caitlin to get 77% off.
For those of you who don't know, Bill and Britt at Punished Props are expert prop makers and costume makers, and we are decorating this.
This is our water blaster. We thought it'd be really cool to design an emblem with both of our logos to commemorate the project. We're gonna design that, 3D print it, cast silicone into the mold.
And then pour molten metal into the silicone mold.
Yeah. Cooking show magic, the 3D print is done. Let's check it out.
So now we'll clean it up with alcohol and prep it for mold making.
Woo!
Ta-da! That's so pretty.
We're using a tin cure silicone mold Max 60, and it shouldn't react with this resin. But just in case we're gonna we'll UV cure it and then we'll prime it.
Cool.
And the back doesn't matter, we'll just throw it on the floor.
We're gonna make a little mold box from some scraps and a cup.
We have a high temp silicone. This is like 560 Fahrenheit, but it takes 24 hours to cure. So a normal temp silicone, this still will do 400 degrees Fahrenheit. It's a little low for our pewter, but it'll survive for at least one casting. And I can swap out the normal catalyst for the fast cat catalyst, reducing the curing time from 16 hours to just one, because we're impatient.
Oh my god!
Wow. It would just get everywhere.
Oh my gosh.
You're getting sneak peek?
Oh!
You gotta know the little details. What are we doing now?
We have our pewter.
Yum.
That's gonna go on the stove.
Bill tells me that this is lead-free pewter, which is what you're supposed to use. Lead is bad.
And you can start warming that up.
Okay.
That's about ready to go.
All right, you ready?
Yeah.
All right, go ahead and pour. Just go faster. Go, stop.
Yeah!
Bubbles? It does worry me a little bit.
Why don't we like vibrate it?
No. Let's down there.
Okay.
And just walk away a little bit. I'm wondering what those bubbles are coming from. I'm picturing us peeling it away and it's just a flat disc. The whole thing's just burned away and there's nothing.
That's okay.
So we waited like 20 minutes for it to cool. It's still pretty warm.
I'm so excited. Oh my gosh. What happened?
So the pewter had a very difficult time getting into some of those details.
That's crazy.
Might as well pour the Molmex 60 and just give it another go in that mold tomorrow.
Okay, so the almost high enough temperature silicone didn't quite work. Bill is prepping the highest temperature silicone that we have. So we're gonna see how that one does, and then we will melt down this pewter again and try it a second time.
Lessons learned.
We're gonna try a few new things. We did some research.
Oh.
And we found that pouring vertical might work better. We had to make a metal backing so that we can clamp it.
We also made another mold out of the high temp silicone. So first thing we'll do is take this apart. We did a good job of getting this silicone down in the letters, but this is a much more rigid silicone. I'm willing to bet that some of those are gonna tear off. We'll see.
I think it's gonna do great.
Because Katelyn's an optimist.
You were right!
What? I didn't actually think that!
It did come out a little bit better than this one, but we're gonna give this one the old college try. I wanna cut a flat spot here. Hopefully,
like a funnel?
Yeah! When this comes together, we have a good spot where we can pour and it should flow down in there. Metal will go in and air can come out.
Prediction, the fan will blow this everywhere. It's happening! Yep, it's covering me.
Okay, it's good. Seems good. What could possibly go wrong?
Everything.
That is a lot of metal. We are just about ready to do the pouring.
Quick pour. Oh.
That looks way
better. It didn't bubble.
It didn't bubble.
It didn't
That's
bubble.
A good sign. You guys ready?
I'm ready.
Yeah.
What?
Oh my gosh!
That's
like,
insane!
That's amazing!
That looks so much better!
The thing with your finger!
Yeah. How did you do it? Oh, you did the sandwichy thing.
Yeah.
We did it! We made a sandwich!
I can't tell you guys how happy I am. We don't have to make another mold.
I wonder why it's so much better.
I really think it's the weight. It cooled faster.
Yeah.
And less of it is exposed to oxygen. Again, assumptions. Yeah, I've been meaning to try this for a long time, and let's do it. Careful, don't drink it, or get it in your eyes, or get it on your skin.
Safety Bob approves.
Yeah. All right, so this is gonna be the fun, because it happens almost immediately. Ready? What?
Oh, oh my gosh.
Why is it doing the we need it down in the low spots.
You know what? Get a brush?
Yeah. Oh yeah, there we go, it's going down in the bubbles. We want it in the text because that's what's going to be left when we buff it. Man, air bubbles are like the bane of my existence.
We're going to buff some high spots with steel wool.
So you could just give it a light buff and just have a little bit of like edge shine, or you could really take it off and just leave it in the dark. When I'm doing this type of buffing too, anywhere that there's like text or texture like in here, mm-hmm. I'll really hit that pretty hard so that the edges pop a lot more.
Wow,
so
yeah.
Before or after buffing and before buffing.
Thanks again to NordVPN for making this video possible. If you haven't heard of a VPN or a virtual private network, it's basically like an invisibility cloak and a teleporter for your internet traffic.
With NordVPN, no one can see what you're doing online, which is especially important if you're out and about using public Wi-Fi, a scenario we often find ourselves in when traveling for collaborations and hopping between airports.
You can access thousands of servers in over 60 countries, and all of a sudden your encrypted web traffic will seem to come from there, and you can access content as if you're at that location too.
NordVPN does not log any of your data, they have unlimited bandwidth, and they have a risk-free 30-day money-back guarantee.
Head over to nordvpn.com/Evan and Caitlin to get 77% off a 3-year plan by using code Evan and Caitlin.
All right, guys, this has been so much fun. If you want to see us place this wonderful, amazing looking emblem onto our version 2 Super Soaker, head over to Punished Props YouTube channel right now.
Well, more important than us placing it is like all the amazing decorating.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
This is just kind of the final jewel.
They have made our water blaster look amazing.
Yeah, and they have tons of resources for molding and casting, so check those out on punishedprops.com. And they do a lot more than just that.
We have over 600
100 video tutorials on prop and costume making on our YouTube channel, and you can find out more, including buy some books learning how to make props and costumes over at punishprops.com.
And if you like this video and you want to support our channel, you can check out some of this sweet Evan and Caitlin merch at shopevanandcaitlin.com, or you can go to patreon.com/evanandcaitlin and check out our after show where we are going to be talking about behind the scenes things that happened here. Thank you guys for watching.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
This is a perfect belly flop.
looks like there's like a little ceremony.
That's not even a little bit helpful.
It's like it's finally.
I'm trying to cool it off like soup.
Yes.
What you got going on there, guys?
What's the Stranger Things? Down Under?
It's the Down Under! The Australian version of Stranger Things.
Down Under.
I mean, we're professionals at this now.
Yeah,
we
professionals.
Make dozens of them.
Dozens!
What else can we melt?